All right, guys, for this exercise, we are going to burn this bear's eye in this hairy area. I had some requests for people who needed help with eyes, so I thought this would be a quick little exercise we could all practice with. Now, remember the pupil. This is a bear that I took a picture of at Bearzona, black bear teenager. The dark parts, I'm looking at the photo on my tablet, the dark parts are the upper lid, the pupil, and then there's a line underneath. So we're going to start off with the pupil. I try to do the darker parts first so that I can get an idea where the rest is going to go. The inside is the highlight, the high highlight, and then there's another highlight next to it. It will be burned, but not as dark. Shape of your eye and pupil. The orbs. Now remember when you're doing fur, you have to follow the fur pattern. The blue cover you see on my handpiece is something new I got from Mountain Carvers. It's supposed to put a spacer in between your hand and a lot more air control, airflow. I was curious to see, it was like $3 for $1. Didn't expect them to be plastic though. Yeah, I'm not going to put in every hair. My pin stops. I'm checking my reference. Make sure I'm going in the right spots, in the right direction. For me, I build up the hair, so I don't just... That's why it takes so long for me to get a piece done. And see, this is black fur and hair, so I have to... It comes out as gray. I have to figure out how dark I want to go with. Remember, fur is not all one color. It's multiple colors plus highlights. The one thing I forgot to do was to change my photo into sepia. Either sepia or black and white, it's easier to see your contrast. This is Razortip small shader and pattern transfer tip, but I use it for shading.